Hi, everybody. Thank you for joining. Today, we'll be talking about Google Cloud's approach to extended reality, or XR. I'm Will Ochandarena, product manager at Google Cloud. With me today is Bernard Reinhardt, technical lead for the product. Let's get started. I'll start today by talking about market trends and why XR and immersive technology is rising in importance. Then Bernard will give us an overview of the product that we built. Then I'll walk through some use cases and show what some customers are already doing with the product. And then finally, Bernard will do a quick demonstration of the product, and then we'll close. So let's start out by talking about some of the market trends. We all know that life has changed a lot in the last 2 years. We've been forced to reimagine activities that used to be in person to be done at home. In the process, we've discovered that we actually prefer doing many of these things remotely: working, shopping, learning, and playing. And we're demanding that those at-home experiences be at par or better than the in-person experiences, which requires investing in a new way of doing things. Extended reality promises to be a key enabler of those new experiences. By being immersive, it enables a new level of connection between users and content, users and each other, that isn't possible any other way. And this has huge implications in how you engage with your customers and your employees and how you experience content and services. Various surveys of consumers and brands show tangible business benefits already in XR investment. For example, 64% of leading consumer brands are already starting to invest in immersive experiences, and 61% of consumers say they prefer retailers with augmented reality experiences. 3D ads are quickly becoming mainstream and overcoming a lot of the challenges of traditional ads. They increase click-through rates by 5x, and they increase the time users interact with the ad by 4x. On the employee engagement side, 59% of executives surveyed said they expect to make multi-million dollar investments in employee XR learning in the next 2 years. And this isn't just in one or two industries, it's several. This is a graph that's sorted from left to right based on relative interest in immersive technology. So the most interest is coming from automotive and retail, followed closely by healthcare and real estate. And this is consistent with what we're seeing in our customer base, with several of our early customers coming from the leftmost sectors. Another reason this is taking off now is real-time 3D hardware and software, historically used for 3D video games, is improving at a staggering pace. With each new generation of hardware and engine technology, visual quality of experiences improves. And this, they've recently become capable of photorealism. But there's a caveat. Photorealism requires the computing power only available today on desktop. And it's going to be this way for a while. Mobile phones have the power that desktops had 10 plus years ago. So while the red line shows what mobile phones are capable of, this is at full power, full battery draw and heat, so you don't necessarily want to push them that hard. Despite the optimism and investment, some challenges exist with existing solutions. The first is what it's like to bring users into the immersive experience. Most of the time, you need users to download an app, which just adds friction to the experience. Next, there's the issue of computing power that I mentioned earlier. Users on their preferred device or mobile can't access compelling photorealistic experiences. Last, developers of these experiences have challenges with compatibility, dealing with multiple mobile operating systems, device models, multiple years, and ultimately vastly different capabilities. So to allow companies to delve successfully into XR while overcoming these challenges, we built Immersive Stream for XR and launched it into public preview. It delivers frictionless, photorealistic XR for everyone, and it's powered by Google Cloud.